Is it focus? I can't tell. Hey y'all, what is up? Welcome back to my channel. It's your girl Juju. Y'all already know what's up. If you are new to my channel, welcome. And if you are not new, welcome back to my channel. And I am so excited to have all of y'all here. So anyways, today I'm going to be covering a video talking about... hold on, let me get my notes. It's a video going over how I managed being a D1 athlete and just kind of my advice to incoming freshman athletes, because this is stuff I wish I knew before I got to college and had to deal with like all the different things, you know what I mean, and still having to get stuff done. Yeah, so I'm gonna be a little big sister. I did get this request from Instagram. I asked my followers to give me some requests on what y'all want to see on YouTube, and I would make sure I shout y'all out because I appreciate y'all so much and I always am open to different ideas. Okay, today's video request came from my girl Sydney. I actually trained with Sydney. We both trained with Coach Will for Fast University. If y'all don't already, y'all should definitely check him out. He's amazing. But Sydney is also amazing. She's a phenomenal athlete, great track athlete, and I can't wait to see what she does in college, y'all. Sydney, thank you so much for this idea. I miss you. I hope you're doing good. And because I take a lot of ideas from my followers on Instagram, that's why you should go follow me. That's why I let y'all have the floor, baby. All right, so anyways, let me get on with this video. Go follow my Instagram if you don't already. Y'all like my shirt? I made it. So here is how I, Jalaiya Bartley, managed being a D1 track and field athlete while being a student as well and doing schoolwork and all this different stuff. As y'all know, being a D1 athlete comes with a lot of things. You literally have to go to practice, you have competitions, you have travel, you have schoolwork, you have studying. It's a lot all compiled in one, and you have to know how to balance it. So here it is. Number one. And I know you've heard it a lot because it's important, and it has to be repeated because it is that important. Prioritize, y'all. Please prioritize. I'm not playing with y'all. Prioritizing is literally the utmost importance while being a D1 athlete. A lot of athletes go into college thinking like, oh, I'm an athlete, I'm here for my sport. Wrong. That's why it's called student athlete. Y'all hear how the student come before the athlete? Yeah. Coaches look at your school, like your schoolwork, your grades. Coaches look at that, y'all. They're not just looking for good athletes. You can be a great athlete, like amazing, and you have the worst grades, and a coach would be like, I don't know. Like, nah, because she or he will be a lot of work to deal with. You don't want that. So think of your academics just as important as your sport. You want to be the athlete that coaches and academic advisors, they know you're going to get your stuff done and they don't have to be on your every call. You know what I mean? Because they will call you. They will stay on your butt. I'm not speaking from experience because I have always been on my grind. Actually, I'm gonna brag a little. I made Dean's List. You know, I got awards for my academics. So I'm not speaking from experience, but I am speaking from having friends that are athletes go through that. The academic advisor is constantly on them about, did you do this? Did you, like, you don't want to be that athlete. You do not want to be that, okay? Be independent. Get your work done. Prioritize. So now that I just let y'all know prioritizing is important, it's gonna set you up in the long run, y'all. Let me talk about how you can prioritize. This is my favorite part. Prioritizing. Here's how you do it. So one way that helped me prioritize so easily, I mean, it ain't never that easy, but like, you know, as easy as it can be, is having a notebook. I know y'all are like, duh, but no, have a notebook. Dang, can I speak? A notebook specifically for, okay, you can use a planner. I personally don't like planners just because planners don't work well with me. So I just get a actual notebook and I write to do, and then I write the date, and then I write boxes. You know, I put a box and write everything I need to do for each class. And I go through and check off everything I get done. So my favorite thing to do in that instance is go to my favorite like coffee shop. You can find like your favorite place, a place that relaxes your mind, a place you can concentrate. That could be a library, Starbucks, a bookstore, like whatever helps you. Take a day out of your week. My day was normally Sundays right before school started. So Sunday I'd wake up kind of early so I can go to a coffee shop, you know, get my morning boost. And I bring my laptop, my book bag, my everything, my notebook in hand, and I'm ready. All right. So what you do, you go through all of your classes, all of them. So let me give you an example. I had ASL. All right, ASL 201. And then below that, I start my boxes, you know, and writing out each assignment I have to do. If I have to study for something, that's going right under ASL. I skip a line, write my next class, and do the same thing, and I do that for all my classes. So once you have exactly what you need to get done for that week, y'all, that day, you can get 2 assignments done at least, okay? Some teachers open things on Monday, some open on Sunday. If they're open on Sunday, why not get ahead of the game? You're probably wondering, okay, that's great, but what about like when I'm traveling? What about when I got practice for hours? What about when? What about? What about? What about? It's always what about, right? So let's talk about what about. We traveled a lot during seasons. With track and field or sports in general, you are traveling often, guys. And it can be really hard balancing school and sports because you're like, whoa, dang. I ain't got no time. And you're right, you really don't have any time. And that's where prioritizing comes in, because you gotta make time. You gotta work through that time, okay? So I remember very specifically this one trip, I think it was like an 8-hour drive. So we were on the bus for 8 hours and it was gonna be a long one. So we had a bus where like the beds, they have beds that you can fold out. There's a flat screen TV. And then you're in a bus with all of your teammates. That can be a time for you to talk to your teammates, joke around, watch TV, whatever. Or that can be a time for you to get your work done. So then when you're at the hotel, you make it to where you have to go, you don't have to worry about that. So if I can find this video, you will see my laptop right in front of me. You see my notebook there, maybe. During that time, I was getting my work done. And I am not saying shut out the world, because while I was doing my work, me and Megan were still talking every now and then. She was also doing her work, so we would pause sometimes to get a breather, talk, and then we're back working. Or I would pause and look up at the movie, start laughing, whatever, watch it for a little bit, and then I'm back to work. So you know, it's like, you have to find times to get your work done. In the airport, while we have that wait time, we have like 2 hours or an hour, whatever we have, I use that time to get my work done. Once again, put your headphones in. Once you got them headphones in, let people know that is not my time to talk and that's not your time to talk to me. Clear all distractions. Do what you have to do. I am telling you, use the times when you are traveling and you have 8 hours or 5 hours, however long the bus ride is, 2 hours. Use that time to get your work done. It's gonna help you so much. Because then when you get to the hotel and you're like, dang, I have competition in the morning, but I have all the schoolwork to do. Now you're thinking about the schoolwork and trying to finish that on time rather than your competition. But you should be thinking about your competition now. Like, you know what I mean? So you like try to get your schoolwork done before you get to your competition, before you get to your destination. And I'm not saying you can't do it there, because there have been so many times, you can go look at my previous vlogs where I'm at the hotel and I'll just go by myself, like where the coffee at or whatever, and I'm doing my work. So don't think you can't do that, okay? I'm not trying to say that at all. Sorry, y'all. Thanks, COVID. So when we get off the topic of traveling and you're like, okay, what about practice? Like, depending on your practice times, depending on your competition, that depends on when you do your work, okay? Let's say you have a morning practice. Okay, get up, get your breakfast, get your coffee, whatever you need. Go to practice. After practice, like, space out. Give yourself maybe an hour. Let's say I end practice at 10 a.m. I'm gonna shower. Maybe I can nap, whatever. And then on your schedule, put like 12 or 1 p.m. Go to the library. Do an hour of work, and then for that entire hour, shut off the world and get your work done. You can get so much done in an hour. You have no idea, y'all. I literally could go on for hours about how I prioritize, but long story short, getting a notebook, writing down exactly what you have to do at the beginning of the week, before that week. So like I said, I do it on Sundays most of the time. That's so rewarding, being like checking the boxes off. I love it. Okay, but anyways, also as an athlete, as any college student in general, we know what goes on. Parties, bars, whatever else there is you do, okay? That does not come before your school. That does not come before your sport. You can have fun. Go have fun. You want to get that college experience. I'm not saying don't do anything and just, no, school, track, school, football, school, whatever, whatever your sport is, whatever. I'm not saying that, but I am saying prioritize. You see how important prioritizing is? So if you know there's a big party going on during the weekend, you better use that week to get your schoolwork done. So if the weekend come up and you didn't get your schoolwork done, now you're like, dang, at 11:59, my schoolwork due. And I haven't even started it. Now you're debating, can I even go to this party? Or you're gonna decide to go to that party and then not turn in your stuff. Like, you know what I mean? And I prefer trying to get everything done before Friday. That's literally always my goal. Because most of the time we either travel on like a Thursday or a Friday. So if I can get my schoolwork done before we travel or before I know something's going on during the weekend, I can just relax. I can just have fun. I can do what I wanna do without thinking about, goodness, I did not get my schoolwork done. Don't procrastinate. Use your time wisely. Something that's also very important, getting an adequate, look at me, can't even, adequate, is that right? Yeah, whatever. Get a good sleep schedule, okay? Because I found the times when my sleep, Words are hard. I found the times when my sleep schedule was messed up and I was going to bed at like 2 a.m. or whatever it may be, I had the hardest time staying on top of things. So if you can get a good sleep schedule, that will also help with managing being a D1 athlete, because you got practice, you're going to be tired, you got competition, you're going to be tired, you got traveling, you are going to be tired. I don't think you're understanding what I'm saying. You're going to be tired as a D1 athlete. Okay? Your time is limited. Use it wisely. That's literally how I manage being a D1 athlete. It's not an easy task being an athlete in college in general, whether that's D1, D2, D3. It's not an easy task. There's a lot that goes on. People don't even realize just the extent of how busy you're gonna be. Being an athlete is way more challenging than people who aren't athletes would know. There's so much that goes into it. It can be a lot, but like if you prioritize right and you do your best at managing your time, you will have such an amazing time. You really will. And you'll be able to enjoy your college experience. You won't be stressed the whole time. I hope this helped. I hope this wasn't all over the place, because in my mind it kind of was, but then I'm always all over the place. Prioritize, y'all. Okay? I love y'all. Thank you so much for watching this. If this helped you, please give it a thumbs up. If you're wanting more advice or I didn't answer a specific thing that you had a question about, please feel free to leave it in the comments. I am always here. I'm always going to be answering questions for y'all, and I have something very exciting coming up on my YouTube channel. It's dealing with athletics. Just so y'all know that I see y'all, I hear you, I know most of my audience are athletic, so I'm not gonna completely stray away from it. So anyways, give it a thumbs up, please subscribe to my YouTube channel, and go follow my Instagram. We can be BFFs, okay? All right, but no, seriously, I wanna be here to help y'all. I will always be here to help y'all. I really hope this helped. I hope this wasn't all over the place, because my mind works that way, okay? Okay, I hope so. I love y'all so much. Thank you again for watching. And I love y'all. Bye.